हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू न्यू टॉपिक, असर्टेनमेंट एंड ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट प्रायर टू इनकॉर्पोरेशन। लाइक, सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर माय चैनल। नाउ यू हैव इन योर माइंड दैट व्हाट इज द प्रॉफिट प्रायर टू इनकॉर्पोरेशन, व्हाट इज द इनकॉर्पोरेशन, why we need to find out the profit prior to incorporation. Okay. This situation is arise when the new company takes over the existing business from the vendor or the partnership firm. Okay, and when new company takes over the existing business, they continue their vendor's business, but their incorporation is in process. You already know that for starting new company there are four steps. For the private limited company there are two steps. First one is a promotion and second one is incorporation. And for the public limited company there are four steps. First one is promotion, second one is incorporation, next capital collection, and last business obtaining certificate of commencement of business. Okay. Both the companies, means a private limited company or public limited company, can start their business on his name from the date of obtaining certificate of incorporation of business. Okay, but when the new company takes over the existing business, at that time the new company, even though they are not registered in the at the current moment, when they purchase the business of the old firm or the sole proprietorship, they continue their vendor's business. At that time the profit earned prior to incorporation of the company, that we need to treat as a capital profit, and after the incorporation of company we need to consider as a revenue profit. Okay, that's why in this situation we need to create the final account or the profit and loss account in the columnar form, that is pre incorporation period and post incorporation period. We need to find out the separate profit for the pre incorporation and post incorporation period. Profit prior to incorporation means the profit earned between the date of acquisition of business and the date of incorporation. Okay, such situation arises in the first year of operation of the company when the same books of accounts of the vendors are continued by the promoters. The profit and loss prior to incorporation is determined notionally by allocating various income and expenses, profit or losses, for the entire period in pre and post incorporation between two time period and appropriate logical basis. Now, what is the treatment of pre-incorporation profit or loss and post-incorporation profit and loss? Okay, profit earned up to the date of incorporation is pre-incorporation profit. Okay, and it is also called as actually that profit is of capital nature. Okay. It is a capital profit and we need to transfer this capital profit to the capital reserve account. Okay, we are going to prepare the P&L account in columnar form. In that P&L account you will find 2 rupees column, that first rupees column related to pre-incorporation and second rupees column is related to the post-incorporation period. So pre-incorporation period profit we need to transfer it to the capital reserve account. Okay, and post incorporation pre incorporation, if there is a loss in pre incorporation period, that loss we need to transfer to the goodwill account. Okay, profit is transferred to the capital reserve account and loss is transferred to the goodwill account. Okay, just keep in mind this thing. Actually profit is transferred to the capital reserve account, that means pre incorporation profit is transferred to the capital reserve account, and pre-incorporation loss, if there is a loss in pre-incorporation period, that loss is transferred to the goodwill account. Okay, एंड नेक्स्ट वट इज द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन प्रॉफिट और लॉस. ओके, पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस इज अ रेवेन्यू इन नेचर. ओके, दैट वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर टू द नेट प्रॉफिट. ओके, इफ देर इज अ लॉस देन वी कैन मेंशन इट बाय नेट लॉस एंड इफ देर इज अ प्रॉफिट वी विल मेंशन टू नेट प्रॉफिट. ओके, लाइक दैट वी ट्रांसफर द प्री इनकॉर्पोरेशन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. ओके, नाउ फॉर फाइंडिंग आउट द प्री इनकॉर्पोरेशन एंड पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन प्रॉफिट और लॉस वी नीड टू बायफर्केट द एक्सपेंसेस इन टू प्री एंड पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन पीरियड. ओके, फॉर दैट वी नीड टू यूज सम लॉजिकल बेसिस. वी नीड टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट दैट प्रॉफिट और लॉस इन लॉजिकल बेसिस. ओके, दैट मीन्स एक्सपेंसिस एंड इनकम वी नीड टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इन एक्चुअली फोर रेशियो. ओके, फर्स्ट वन इज टाइम रेशियो, नेक्स्ट इज सेल्स रेशियो, नेक्स्ट सम एक्सपेंसेस और इनकम वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर इन प्री पीरियड ओनली एंड सम एक्सपेंसेस और इनकम वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर टू द पोस्ट पीरियड ओनली. ओके, देयरफॉर देयर आर फोर बेसिस वी नीड टू यूज टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द इनकम एंड एक्सपेंसेस बिटवीन प्री एंड पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन पीरियड. डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द इनकम एंड एक्सपेंसेस इन प्री एंड पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन पीरियड. दैट मीन्स फर्स्ट इज टाइम रेशियो, नेक्स्ट इज सेल्स रेशियो, नेक्स्ट इज प्री इनकॉर्पोरेशन पीरियड एंड लास्ट वन इज पोस्ट इनकॉर्पोरेशन पीरियड. ओके, नाउ हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द टाइम रेशियो. ओके, कैलकुलेशन ऑफ टाइम रेशियो इज वेरी सिंपल. ओके, एवरी टाइम यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर दिस वर्किंग नोट दैट इज कैलकुलेशन ऑफ टाइम रेशियो. ओके, फॉर दैट यू जस्ट नीड थ्री डेट्स. That is date of beginning of year, next date of incorporation and last one is date of year end. Just keep in mind when the new company acquire the running business at that time in the first year, that first year may be of it is not compulsory that that period is restricted to the only 12 months. Okay, that first year may be of 9 months also or the 18 months also or 15 months also, that depends on the actually company's that depends on the situation actually. You just need to find out how many months are there in pre period and post period very accurately. Okay, because calculation of time ratio is very essential and very important. If you are not able to find out that time ratio accurately, you will lose half of the marks of that problem, because calculation of time ratio, they have the separate marks for that also, and around 40-50% expenses are related to the time ratio. That's why we need to calculate this ratio very accurately. Okay, time ratio is used for dividing fixed expenses. Okay, you can simply keep in mind that other than sales expenses, we need to distribute that expenses in time ratio. That is mostly that expenses are in fixed nature actually, that are fixed expenses. That means the rent, salary, wages, interest. Okay, that expenses we need to distribute in time ratio. Okay, pre-incorporation period consists of the business acquired up to the date of incorporation, and post-incorporation start from the date of incorporation till the accounting year end. The entire period is normally of a year, normally, not compulsorily. But it can be longer or shorter period also depending upon the situation. That means that first year may be of 9 months or 15 months also. Okay, just you need to see the problem, or you need to read the problem very accurately so that you will able to find out the accurate months. Okay, for that you for calculation of time ratio, you just need the three dates, just date of beginning of year, date of incorporation and date of year end. Just calculate the months in between these two dates, that is from the date of beginning of year to the date of incorporation. Now calculate it April, May and June, not July, because the date is in date of incorporation is 1st July, so we should not include that July in the pre-incorporation period, because 1st July is the incorporation date. That means the July is the month which is in post incorporation period. That means only 3 months are related to the pre incorporation period. That means April, May and June, that is 3 months. You just need to calculate the difference months from the beginning of year to the date of incorporation, that is 3 months, and from the date of incorporation to the date of year end, that is post incorporation period, that is 9 months. Just calculate the month and then calculate the ratio. 3:9, that is 1:3. Okay, it's very simple, and every time we have the fixed formula or fixed working note for the calculation of time ratio. There is no other formula or other method for calculation of time ratio. Just you need to find out these three dates. Okay, sometimes you will be provided with the date of commencement of business also in the problem, but we no need to consider that date of commencement of business for the calculation of time ratio. For the calculation of time ratio, you must have consider these three dates, that is date of beginning of year, date of incorporation, and date of year end. Okay, now let's see how to calculate the sales ratio. Okay, sales ratio is used for dividing the gross profit, variable expenses, sales expenses, etc. Sales ratio is calculated by comparing sales of pre and post incorporation period. However, if sales are not even uniform per month, then weighted average sales ratio should be calculated. Okay, sales ratio are used to distribute the income and expenses, sales expenses or income. Now, how to calculate the sales ratio? Okay, there are various methods, or you will find the different problem. There are different situations for calculation of the sales ratio. But for the time ratio, if you see the various problem at that time, you will find that time for calculation of time ratio, there is a fixed formula or fixed method. Okay, that we just see just now actually. Okay, but for calculation of sales ratio, there are different situation. I am showing you the two of the situation here. Okay, in the problem you will be provided with the net sales, that is 16 lakhs. And also you will provide with the pre-incorporation sales or the post-incorporation sales. Okay, if the pre-incorporation sales is provided in the problem, at that time you can find out these two information is provided in the problem, and you can find out this information for calculation of the sales ratio. Okay, now you are provided with the total sales and the pre-incorporation sale. From that information, you can find out the post incorporation sale by using this formula: net sales minus pre incorporation sale. You will find the post incorporation sale, that is 11 lakhs. 16 lakhs minus 5 lakhs is equal to 11 lakhs. Okay, now you can simply calculate the ratio of pre period sales and post period sales, that is 5 lakh is to 11 lakh. That means the sales ratio is 5:11. This is the one method of calculation of the sales ratio. Okay, one method means as per the problem situation, you need to find out the sales. In some problem you will be provided with this information, okay, and in some problem you will be provided with this situation also. Okay, just read how to calculate the sales ratio in this situation. Okay, D was incorporated on 1st July 2014. This is the incorporation date. Okay, to take over the business from 1st April 2014. Okay, that means this is the beginning of year, 1st April 2014. This is the incorporation date. And for the period ending 31st March 2015, this is the year end date. Okay, trend of the sales were as under. We are also provided with the sales information. Monthly sales were double from the July 2014 and again from the 1st January 2015. Monthly sales were double that of December 2014 months. Okay, that means before the 1st July, the sales were uniform and average sales. From the 1st July, that sales are double from the previous month. Okay, and for this calculation, you just need to mention all the months in this fashion. Okay, from April. Okay, from April to March. April, May, June, July. Okay, March, up to March. Okay. Now mention this information in this chart. Up to 1st July 2014, it was average. That means up to June, because 1st July, from 1st July it was double. Okay, so April, May, June, the one we need to mention only one. From the July we need to mention two, because from the earlier month it was the sales were double. That means from July it was double. Again from the 1st January 2015 monthly sale were double that of December. That means up to December we need to mention 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 and 2 up to December. And from the January onwards it is again double that of December 2014. That means in the December it was 2, okay, 2 rupees sale was in the December. That means from the January it will be double, that is 2 into 2 that is 4, okay, from the January, February, March it will be 4 4 4, okay, like that. We just need to mention this. That means if there is average, we just need to mention 1. If there is a double, we just need to mention 2, okay, and that double is again double actually. That's why we just mentioned that in the December it was 2, in the January it will be 4, okay, because it was again double from the January 2015, okay. That's why we just need to mention 4 4 4, okay. Now the splitting point is the date of incorporation. In every situation your splitting point is the date of incorporation. That date of incorporation is 1st July. That means July month is in the post incorporation period. That's why I have splitted this actually information from this point of view. This point actually up to June it is pre incorporation period, and from the July it is post incorporation period. Just split it and count it. This pre incorporation there are 1 2 3, and in the post incorporation there are 24. Just count it. 2 plus 2 4 6 8 10 12 16 20 and 24, okay, that is 24, okay. Now calculate the sales ratio. 3 is to 24, that is 1 is to 8, okay. This is the another method of calculation of sales ratio, okay. Just when you are provided with the sales information, that monthly sales information, just you need to mention the all the months and mention the detail information in detail information about the every month below that month, and just bifurcate that information by splitting it in pre and post incorporation period, okay. From 1st July it is post incorporation period is started, so from 1st July post incorporation and up to 1st July it is pre-incorporation period. Just count it and calculate the sales ratio, okay. This is the second method of calculation of sales ratio, okay. You just need to calculate these two ratio only, okay, and other information which are related to working note, okay, or adjustment, okay. Just in the problem you will come to know how to calculate the other information, okay. Now I am going to show you the basis of allocation. Just I have already told you that we need to bifurcate that expenses in these four ratio. First ratio is time ratio, next sales ratio, next pre-incorporation period, and last one is post-incorporation period. I have just mentioned here the which expenses we need to bifurcate in which ratio. That is time ratio. We just need to bifurcate these expenses in the time ratio. All these expenses are in fixed in nature. Fixed nature income and expenses, that is salary, rent and rates, interest, depreciation, audit fee. These are expenses we need to distribute in time ratio. Next expenses related to sales ratio. Sales expenses, variable expenses and income we need to bifurcate in sales ratio. Okay, just keep in mind that is gross profit is always distributed in sales ratio. Okay, you will not be given any information about the gross profit. That gross profit we need to distribute in sales ratio. You will also have the fill in the blanks or match the pairs related to this also. That gross profit is distributed in which ratio? Okay, the answer is sales ratio. Okay, then all the other sales expenses. All the expenses are sales expenses. That is advertisement, bad debt, selling expenses, free sample. That means advertisement, variable expenses, carriage on sales, commission on sales, discount allowed, distribution expenses. All the expenses are sales expenses. That all the sales expenses we need to distribute it in sales ratio. Next is pre-incorporation period. Okay, some expenses are purely related to the vendors. That means the person from whom we purchase the business, that new company purchase the business, that vendor firm or the partner. if the vendor is a firm, at that time the partners related, all the partners of the vendors firm, that expenses or income related to vendors or partners we need to transfer to the pre-incorporation, in the pre-incorporation period. That means we need to transfer that expenses in pre-period only. Okay, just I have also mentioned here one note that interest paid to vendor, excluding interest paid to vendor. That means if they in the problem we are provided with the interest paid to vendor, at that time we need to calculate the specific time ratio for distribution of interest paid to vendor. That interest paid to vendor is not transferred to transfer in pre-incorporation period. Just we need to calculate the specific time ratio for that. Okay, we will see in the problem also how to calculate the specific time ratio. And last period is post-incorporation period. That means expenses or income related to company. Okay, all the expenses or income related to purely related to company that we need to transfer to the post-incorporation period. Now, which expenses are related to purely to the company, purely related to the company? These four expenses. That means expenses or income related to shares, debentures, directors, and company formation. Okay, these four things we need to transfer to the post-incorporation period. Expenses are related to shares, debentures, directors, and company formation. Okay, that means share issue expenses, debenture issue expenses, company formation expenses, directors remuneration, directors fee, MD remuneration, managing directors remuneration, etc. expenses, etc. Just we need to transfer to the post-incorporation period. Okay, this chart is very important. Which expenses we need to transfer in which ratio? Okay. Now, this is the format of preparation of profit and loss account. Actually, there are two formats. One is horizontal format, or another is the vertical format. Okay. In the vertical format, this information is written in at the beginning of the format, and these all the information or the all the expenses are deducted from this information, from the income information. You will find the net profit or net loss. Okay, and this is the horizontal format or T format. Just we need to prepare the profit and loss account in this format. That means debit side, particular basis column, in which ratio we are going to transfer this distribute these expenses in pre and post incorporation period. That basis we need to mention here. Next, pre-incorporation rupees, post-incorporation rupees. Again, at the credit side, particular basis, pre-rupees, post-rupees. This is the format for preparation of profit and loss account. Okay. Now, while preparing the final account, you can prepare trading account as it is, as you were preparing earlier. Okay, trading, the format of trading account is same. As you are preparing earlier, just you need to bifurcate that gross profit in the profit and loss account. You just need to bifurcate that gross profit in sales ratio. Okay, that is a trading account output. Okay, gross profit or gross loss. Okay, just you need to distribute in sales ratio. Okay, and format of balance sheet is same. Okay. That we need to just we were preparing earlier, because we are not going to distribute that income and expenses in balance sheet actually, because balance sheet is a statement of assets and liability. Okay, that format of the balance sheet is same as we were preparing earlier. Okay, so just you need to prepare the profit and loss account in columnar form. The trading account and balance sheet is same as it is. But normally in the problem you will ask to prepare only P&L account only, not the balance sheet and the trading account. But there are some problem in that you will ask to prepare that trading account and P&L account also, sorry, that trading account and balance sheet as well. Okay, but while preparing that trading account and balance sheet, you just need to follow the basic rule, earlier rule that you were following earlier. Okay, there is no difference between the pre and post incorporation period. Okay, while preparing the balance sheet and the trading account. Okay,
like, subscribe,
and share my channel. Now let's see next problem, that is practical problem. I am going to show you how to solve the practical problem. Okay, this is the problem. I'm just reading it, the problem actually. From this information you we can prepare the time ratio, or the find out the trading time ratio. Jai Limited was incorporated on 1st June 2020 to take over the running business of JR and Company with effect from 1st April 2020. That means purchase date, that means the date of beginning of year is the 1st April and incorporation date is 1st June. The same books of accounts continued and followed and following the profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2021. This is the year end date. Okay, we are provided with the P&L account for the year ended 31st March 2020. Okay, these are the expenses and these are the income. Okay, and the other information related to this problem, that furniture was sold on 31st March 2021. Okay, in this chart we come to know that actually which expenses we need to transfer in which ratio, but this is the general rule. Okay, before following this rule you need to consider adjustment first. If there is any adjustment related to rent, then that rent we need to transfer in that adjustment basis, from that adjustment basis and not the earlier rule. That earlier rule, that in the as per the earlier rule we need to distribute that rent in time ratio. Okay, and here also we are given the information related to the advertisement. Earlier we will distribute that advertisement expenses in sales ratio, but when you are provided with the adjustment related to the some items of income and expenditure, that adjustment we should follow first, after that the general rule. This thing just keep in mind, otherwise you will say that earlier we are going to distribute that advertisement expenses in sales ratio, but in this problem we will distribute that in sales and time ratio as well. Okay, as per the adjustment. Okay, so just I'm reading the adjustment here. The adjustment like information. Earlier in the final account, that adjustment, when there is any adjustment, there will be two effect. Okay, but these are the some of the information. Okay, and these are not all adjustment type information. Okay, furniture was sold on 31st March 2021. Okay, if you see the problem, you will find that loss on sale of old furniture is provided in the at the debit side of P&L account, and that furniture is sold on 31st March 2021. That means at the year end date. Okay, so this information we need to transfer to the post period only, because that 31st March 2021 is the post period. Okay, that means that loss is happened in the post period only. That means this expenses or loss we need to transfer in the post period only. Okay, this is the first adjustment or the information. Next information, monthly average sales were double from the 1st January 2021. Okay, this information we have provided to calculate. We are provided with to calculate the sales ratio. Okay, that monthly sales were double from 1st January 2021. Next information, 50% advertisement expenses were related to the sales and balance expenses for the outdoor advertising were paid on monthly basis. Okay, some expenses are paid on monthly basis, that means that expenses are fixed. That means 50% expenses are related to sales and 50% expenses are related to time basis. Okay, so for a calculation of advertisement expenses, for distribution of advertisement expenses, 50% we need to distribute 50% in sales ratio and another 50% in time ratio. Okay, because these are the fixed nature and these are on the basis of sales. Okay, 50% on sales basis and 50% on time basis. Okay, and last information we are given, purchase consideration was settled on 31st July 2020 along with the interest due up to that date. Okay, now in this chart also I have told you that interest paid to vendor is distributed in specific time ratio. That specific time ratio means we just need to calculate the another time ratio. In that time ratio you just need to consider beginning of the year, date of incorporation and purchase consideration payment date. Okay, on this three dates we need to calculate the specific time ratio for distribution of interest paid to vendor. Okay, that interest is paid to vendor on that purchase consideration. Okay, so we just need to distribute that interest paid to vendor in specific time ratio. For that we need to calculate the specific time ratio. Okay, now just I'm going to show you. Okay, before that we will just see which expenses we will distribute in which ratio before considering this adjustment. Actually, salaries in time ratio, office rate time ratio, printing and stationery time ratio, director's fee, it is related to director, that means in the post period, sundry expenses time ratio, depreciation time ratio, advertisement related to sales expenses, sales ratio, preliminary expenses written off, that means company formation expenses. Okay, post period, sales commission, sales ratio, loss on sale of old furniture, that is related to the post period as per the adjustment. Okay, next, audit fee, time ratio, gross profit, sales ratio, discount on, actual discount we need to distribute in sales ratio, share transfer fee related to shares, that means post period, MD remuneration, MD means managing director's remuneration, directors related post nature, post for the post period, partner salary, it is related to partners, pre period, interest paid to vendor, specific time ratio as per fourth adjustment, debenture interest post period, it is related to debentures, discount on issue of debenture related to the debenture post period. Okay, and advertisement expenses we need to distribute in time and sales ratio, in both the ratio as per the adjustment number 3. Okay, now let's calculate the time ratio. How to calculate the time ratio? It's same formula. Okay, same formula, same method, just you need to mention the three dates, date of beginning of year. Okay, that is 1st April 2020, next date of incorporation, that is 1st June 2020, and date of year end 31st March 2020. Okay, just mention the these three dates. And after that, just find out the different difference between these two dates, that is April, May. Okay, June is the month related to the post period, because 1st June is the date of incorporation. That means June period, June month is also related to the post incorporation period. That means only 2 months are related to pre-incorporation period. 2 months, April and May. Okay, 2 months. And in the post incorporation period, there are 10 months, that means June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February and March. Okay, that means 10 months are related to the post incorporation period. So the time ratio is 2:10, that is 1:5. 1:5 is the time ratio. Okay, now next, calculate the sales ratio. For the calculation of sales ratio, we are given with the this information, that is monthly average sales were double from January. Okay, that means earlier it was single, that is average, and from the January 2021 it was double. So up to the December, just we need to mention 11, and from the January onwards we just need to mention 2, that is double of the average period. Okay, average sales, that is 2 2 2. After mentioning this 1 and 2, 1 or 2 as per the situation, you just need to split this information on the basis of date of incorporation. Date of incorporation is 1st June, that means June month is in the post period. Okay, now calculate. Okay, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, and this the total of this all the 10 months is 13. So the 2:13 is the sales ratio. Okay, sales ratio is 2:13. Okay, after calculating the time ratio and sales ratio, we will calculate the interest paid to vendor, a specific time ratio. Okay, for the calculation of specific time ratio, we need to find out the period from first, that means the beginning of the year, to the date of incorporation, and from the date of incorporation to the date of payment. The date of payment is 31st July 2020. Okay, date of beginning of year is 1st April 2020. Date of incorporation is 1st June 2020. And date of payment of PC is 31st July 2020. Just calculate the months from April to June, 2 months, April and May, and June and July, 2 months. Okay, therefore the we need to distribute the interest paid to vendor in the 1:1 ratio. This is the specific time ratio. Okay, 1:1 ratio. Okay. And for the third adjustment, 50% of advertisement expenses were related to the sales, and the balance expenses for outdoor advertising were paid on monthly basis. That means this is related to the time ratio, and this is 50% related to the sales ratio. Just we need to distribute that advertisement expenses 50% on sales basis and 50% on time basis. Okay, now I'm showing you the formula for distributing the expenses in the specific ratio, how to find out the pre-incorporation expenses or income, or post-incorporation expenses and income. The formula for that: total of expenses or income. That means if you want to distribute salaries, the ratio for the salaries is time ratio. Okay, because salaries are the fixed expenses, that's why we need to distribute it in time ratio. The total of expenses is ₹48,000. Okay, and time ratio is 1:5. Okay, therefore total of ratio is 6. 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. Pre-incorporation period ratio is 1. And post incorporation period ratio is 5. Okay, for calculating the pre incorporation period expenses is equal to total of expenses or income, that is 48,000 salaries, divided by total of ratio. Total of ratio is 6, 1 plus 5 is equal to 6, into pre incorporation period ratio, that is 1. Okay, therefore calculate it, 48,000 divided by 6 into 1, therefore ₹8,000 for the pre-incorporation period, 8,000, and for the post-incorporation period formula is same, just difference is that into post-incorporation period ratio. The total of expenses or income, that is 48,000, divided by total of ratio is 6, okay, 1 plus 5 is equal to 6, into post-incorporation period ratio, that is 5, 8,000 into 5, that is ₹40,000. Okay, therefore salaries for the pre period ₹8,000, and for the post period ₹40,000. Okay, just like we need to calculate all the expenses and income, just prepare in the books of Jai Limited profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2021. Salaries, the format is particular basis, pre rupees, post rupees. Particular basis, pre rupees, post rupees. Okay, salaries, basis, time ratio. Okay, pre period 8,000, post period 40,000. Just now we have calculated. Okay, for the pre period 8,000, post period ₹40,000. Next expenses, office rent. Office rent ₹12,000. Which ratio we need to distribute it in time ratio. Okay, so time ratio, total of office expenses ₹12,000. So calculate it. For the pre period, total of expenses or income 12,000, divided by total of ratio 6, into total of pre period 1, that is ₹2,000. And for the post period, 2,000 into 5, that is ₹10,000. Okay, that means office rent 2,000 and 10,000 in the ratio, distributed in the time ratio. Next expenses, printing and stationery ₹6,000, printing and stationery is also distributed in the time ratio. Okay, so printing and stationery total of expenses rupees 10,000 distributed in time ratio. Time ratio is 1:5. So calculate it. Total of expenses or income, same formula. Total of expenses or income is equal to 6,000 divided by total of ratio is equal to 6 into 1 for pre period, that is 1,000, and into 5 for post period, that is 5,000. Okay, it's very simple. Just you need to use the same formula for every expenses or income, for distribution of every expenses or income. Next expense is director fee. Okay, director fee, it's related to post period. Because you already know that expenses or income related to shares, debentures, directors and company formation, we need to transfer it to the post period only. Okay, therefore director's fee related to post period only 7,250, directly mention it into the post period. Mention the basis, post, pre period nil, post period 7,250. Okay, next expenses, sundry expenses. Rupees 3,000, okay, we need to distribute it in time ratio, that is 1:5, time ratio is 1:5. So total of expenses or income rupees 3,000, same formula every time, 3,000 divided by 6 into 1 for pre period, that is rupees 500, okay, and into 5 for the post period, that is rupees 2,500. Okay, next expenses is depreciation, rupees 9,000. We also need to distribute depreciation in time ratio. So time ratio is 1:5. Depreciation total amount is 9,000. So use the same formula, 9,000 divided by 6 into 1, that is 1,500 for pre period. And 9,000 divided by 6 into 5 is equal to 7,500 for the post period. Okay, next expenses, advertisement 24,000. And for the advertisement, there is adjustment number 3. In that adjustment, 50% advertisement expenses were related to sales. That means that we need to distribute in sales ratio, and the balance expenses for outdoor advertising were paid on monthly basis. That is related to time. That's why for advertisement expenses, total amount is 24,000. So we need to distribute 12,000 in sales ratio and rupees 12,000 in time ratio. Okay, sales ratio is 2:13. So distribute 12,000 in 2:13 ratio. The total of ratio is 15. 2 plus 13. That is total of ratio is 15. So divide it. 12,000 divided by 15 into 2 for pre period. That is 1,600. Okay, and into 13 for the post period, that is 10,400. Okay, you can verify it also. Just total it. That total should be is equal to rupees 12,000. Okay, 1,600 plus 10,400 is equal to 12,000. Now remaining 50%, we need to distribute in time ratio. The time ratio is 1:5. So distribute it, 12,000 divided by 6 into 1, that is rupees 2,000, and divided by 6 into 5, that is rupees 10,000. Okay, this is advertisement. Okay, next expenses, preliminary expenses return off rupees 2,500. Okay, preliminary expenses means company formation expenses. Okay, so distribute it directly to the post period. Mention it post period, pre period nil, post period 2,500. Total expenses 2,500. Okay. Next expenses, sales commission 42,000. Sales commission, we need to distribute it in sales ratio. Sales ratio is 2:13. Okay. So total expenses 42,000 divided by 15. Okay. Calculate it. 42,000 divided by 15 into 2. For pre period, that is 5,600, and 42,000 divided by 15 into post period, that is 13. Okay, 13 is equal to 36,400, and the total of this 5600 plus 36400 is equal to 42000. Okay, next expenses, loss on sale of old furniture. Okay, for that we have given some information, that is furniture was sold on 31st March 2021, so it is related to purely in the post period. That's why we need to transfer this loss on sale of old furniture in the post period only. Okay, so loss on sale of furniture post, piece period nil, post period total amount rupees 3000. Okay, next expenses, audit fee. Audit fee we need to distribute it in time ratio. Total amount rupees 9000, time ratio is 1:5, the total is total of ratio is 6. Audit fee time ratio 9000 divided by 6 into 1, that is 1500, and 9000 divided by 6 into 5, that is 7500. Okay, audit fee. Next expenses, MD remuneration, that is managing director's remuneration. So it is related to directors, that's why we need to distribute it or transfer it directly in the post period. Okay, 6250. Okay, MD remuneration post period 6250. Okay, next, partner salary, the salary related to the partner, that's why we need to transfer it in the pre period, 1750. Okay, partner salary pre period 1750, post period nil. Okay, next expenses, interest paid to vendor 6000. We have separately calculated the specific time ratio for this, and that specific time ratio is 1:1, so we need to distribute this in 1:1 ratio. Okay, you can mention here working note also, working note number 3, or you can directly mention the that ratio also, 1:1, 3000 3000. Okay, you can simply distribute it in this ratio, 1:1 ratio. Total of expenses 6000 divided by total of ratio 2 into 1 for pre period 3000, and into 1 for post period also 3000. Okay, next expenses, debenture interest, it's related to debenture, that means we need to distribute it or transfer it to the post period only, 14250. Okay, post period pre period nil, post period 14250. Next, discount on issue of shares, issue of debentures, it is also related to debenture, that means this also we need to distribute in or transfer it to the post period only, rupees 4000. Okay, discount on issue of debenture post 4000. Okay, now last is net profit. We no need to distribute it in any ratio actually, just we need to find out the balancing amount for calculation of net profit. Okay, at the credit side, gross profit we need to distribute it in sales ratio, that is sales ratio is total of gross profit is 372,000, sales ratio is 2:13, so 372,000 calculated, 372,000 total of expenses or income, that is 372,000 divided by total of ratio is 15 into 2 for free period 49,600, and into 13 for the post period, that is 322,400. Okay, next, discount earned. Discount we need to distribute it in sales ratio, 5400 total of expenses, so 5400 divided by 15, okay, into 2 for pre period, that is 720, and 5400 divided by 15 into 13, okay, that is 4680. And final amount is share transfer fee. Okay, it is related to shares, that means we need to transfer it to the post period, post period pre period nil, post period 600 rupees. Okay, now we have solved all the problem. Actually, furniture we have already distributed in the post period. We have already calculated this sales ratio, advertisement expenses, and purchase consideration. Okay, we have finished the problem. Actually, just need to find out the balancing amount. Just first find out the पोस्ट पीरियड टोटल क्रेडिट साइड दैट इज 3,27,680, फाइंड आउट द बैलेंसिंग अमाउंट दैट इज 1,58,130. पोस्ट पीरियड प्रॉफिट इज द रेवेन्यू प्रॉफिट, वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर इट टू द नेट प्रॉफिट. ओके, टू नेट प्रॉफिट कैरिड डाउन 1,58,130, दिस इज बैलेंसिंग अमाउंट, एंड कैलकुलेट द बैलेंसिंग अमाउंट ऑफ द प्री पीरियड. द टोटल ऑफ क्रेडिट साइड 50,320. ओके, 50,320 एंड बैलेंसिंग अमाउंट इज 21,870. ओके, दैट प्री पीरियड प्रॉफिट इज ट्रांसफर टू द, वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर इट टू द कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट. इट इज कैपिटल प्रॉफिट, वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर इट टू द कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट दैट इज 21,870. ओके, दैट्स इट. एक्चुअली इट्स दिस एक्चुअली टॉपिक इज वेरी सिंपल. जस्ट ट्राई टू सॉल्व मैक्सिमम प्रॉब्लम. हाउ टू जस्ट सी फॉर द हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द सेल्स रेशियो, बिकॉज इन द सेल्स रेशियो हैज़ अ डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ कैलकुलेशन. फॉर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ टाइम रेशियो ओनली वन मेथड इज देयर. ओके, दैट वी नीड टू यूज द थ्री डेट्स, फर्स्ट बिगिनिंग ऑफ ईयर, नेक्स्ट डेट ऑफ इनकॉर्पोरेशन, लास्ट डेट ऑफ ईयर एंड. ओके, एंड फ्रॉम दैट थ्री डेज वी कैन कैलकुलेट द टाइम रेशियो. फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ सेल्स रेशियो देर आर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मेथड्स इन डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम्स, सो जस्ट चेक फॉर डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ सेल्स रेशियो. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच. ओके, ट्राई टू सॉल्व मैक्सिमम प्रॉब्लम, प्रैक्टिस टू सॉल्व द मैक्सिमम प्रॉब्लम, सी द डिफरेंट एडजस्टमेंट फॉर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम. ओके, हाउ टू सॉल्व द टाइम रेशियो एंड सेल्स रेशियो एंड ऑल अदर एडजस्टमेंट. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच. लाइक, सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर माई चैनल.